My name is Melissa Trachtenberg, and I'm a physician assistant here at Cardiac Arrhythmia Service.
So as a physician assistant, I work as a team with the physicians. I am licensed to practice medicine, I write prescriptions, and I basically do everything the physician does non-invasively. So I've been with the practice for 16 plus years. I have worked closely with all three doctors, and I have also had specific training on device interrogation. So I'm able to both interrogate it, but also troubleshoot the device. I see a variety of patients for different symptoms. So if it's a pacemaker or a defibrillator follow-up, I look to see if they're having any shortness of breath, if they're having any lightheadedness or palpitations, and I correlate that with what I find on the device check. And if we need to make any changes in their medications or with their devices, I do so. For people who I follow for arrhythmias, I ask pretty much the same questions because it'll help me tell whether they're having any arrhythmias in between their office visits. Generally, we see patients in the office prior to scheduling for an ablation, and we do go over what medications they're on. Generally, they are on an anticoagulant or a blood thinner, and usually an antiarrhythmic. And so we'll go over all the medications before we schedule the patient. The pacemaker is something that prevents your heart from going too slow. And a defibrillator is something that prevents your heart from going too slow, but it also has the ability to prevent your heart from going too fast in a very life-threatening sort of way. So you'll come into the office and we'll check the device, and the device will tell me a lot of things. It'll tell me the battery voltage, it'll tell me if you've had any arrhythmias, and it tells me the device function itself. As a physician assistant, I'm licensed to practice medicine, I write prescriptions, and I basically do everything that the physician does non-invasively.